Secret organizations want to gain absolute control over humanity. Religions are calling for a holy war against dissentient brothers. During a dark age, the human mind is directed towards materialism. The negative attributes of his ego are fear, guilt, control, calculation, envy, security, dominance, pride, arrogance, manipulation, and striving for power. His helpers are the present exclusively materialistic social systems. Unlimited growth is like a cancer of mankind within the planetary organism called Earth. Fear for jobs, fear for supplies, fear of diseases. Fear seems to be the prime motivation of all social life.
My personal feeling about the future is that it's coming along pretty fast, and much of the research that we did for the book was done in the 1980s and showed that in the future times there would be a series of great changes, including particularly ecological changes. Perhaps the most positive part was that very few people, one or two out of the 500 or 600 that we worked ultimately with, only saw some kind of nuclear Holocaust. Very, very few people saw that. It doesn't seem to be our future. I personally feel that we have two or three more years to do the preparations that are necessary and possibly to work with the energy fields to change some of these catastrophic situations for the future, or they will be upon us before we realize it. Certainly by the end of this decade.
Everything looks very negative. And among the scientists with inside knowledge, the opinion is spreading that it may be 5 minutes past midnight for the future of Earth and mankind. The train has already departed. Mankind now wants to enter adulthood and has apparently tilted the balance of the planet. Humanity is already stuck in a crisis of evolution. And for some, the downfall of mankind has already begun. For others, the ascension of mankind has started, the great transformation. So the changes on the outside and the inside have already begun. And yet, imperceptibly, in this darkness, a little light has been kindled in order to point out the way to mankind. The arrival of the incarnated light workers, extraterrestrial contents of consciousness, who are to prepare the seed for the new mankind. The pole change towards the spiritual, towards a new golden era, has already started. Instead of living in primeval fear, this new generation is intended to live in primeval trust. Indeed, all the negative events are justified in the cosmic plan, which we do not comprehend with our mind. Because nothing exists outside of the divine plan. Even the chaos is the new order.
Hello, brothers. Hello, sisters. Grüß Gott. I'm Karl, and I am like I am. Just like I am. Thanks God. I know now who I am. Here, I'm love. I'm love, and nothing else is love. Like we all. Like we all. I have nothing to assert, no. Nothing to blame. Nothing to judge. Nobody to accuse. Nobody to accuse, and nobody to convince. Just to be as I am. As an example. Just an example. So I did advertising. I made commercials for products, which we need, like cancer. Cancer. The materialized illusion. The materialized illusion around us. Yes, I didn't know about causes effect. I didn't know about the law of the echo. And suddenly, I got it into me that we are all one, one with everything, and we will unite each other like we never did before. Ha! The artists. The artists. And everybody, last but least, is an artist, yeah? And love artists we are. We are love artists. We come together as children, as we are. Just as children. Because we are children, forever and forever and forever. And we will play the game. We will play. Play, play, play. And the game called love. Love and nothing else as love. Yeah, this is the game. And we'll get free of the materialized illusion around us. The luxury, the materialism, which we need, like cancer. No, no sickness anymore. No sickness anymore. And I got the message into me that fear is an illusion. Fear is an illusion. Ha! Oh, that's wonderful to know. To be ill is an illusion. To hate is an illusion. To make profit is an illusion. And what you see materialized, not in tune with the nature on Mother Earth, is just a materialized illusion and will disappear very, very soon. And this is just the law of the echo, the law, the only law we have. It's the game, yeah, it's the game. But so many forgot about the game, these periods of time, about the game, you know. So we played war, war, one after the other. And the war was happening in us. And we look around us here, then we see war games everywhere, everywhere, war. It's just an illusion. Yeah, war is just an illusion. So we killed, and the main part of us kill animals, animals, yeah. Also our brothers, our sisters, yeah. And we didn't know that we kill ourselves. We didn't know. Whatever we kill ourselves. And whatever we do with the nature, we do it with ourselves. Yeah, we do it with ourselves. Because we are the nature. We are the land. We are one with everything.
Old prophecies tell that at the end of the Dark Age, the keepers of the higher evolution, extraterrestrials of the Galactic Confederation, will return to Earth in their lightships in order to supervise the process of ascension. After humanity moved into the Atomic Age, the keepers descended to Earth and warned the governments about the consequences of atomic war. In 1952, members of the Galactic Confederation met President Eisenhower of the USA. But his hands were tied because the official US government was backed by the world government of the Illuminati, which rejected a military disarmament.
I was chosen as the G2 heir for that particular project, which was highly sensitive and classified. And as a result of that, I was in charge of aerial phenomena, you might say. So all aerial phenomena came through the A2, which was the Air Force representative, and the G2, which was the Army representative, myself. One day, we received a Twix from higher headquarters, which was called the 3rd Army Headquarters. Came down to division, and actually Corps first, then the division, and then to us in the Air Force. And it was an emergency cable, or Twix, which simply stated that an unidentified flying object had landed, soft landed, in White Sands, New Mexico. The first initial Twix indicated that they had it under observation. They were going to watch it for 24 hours, hoping there would be some type of life aboard and they could communicate with it and get on with the possible acceptance.